Petri dishes.
Classroom.
Hello, hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to science class. And today we're going to go over some of the cool stuff we're doing with our Petri dish lab. Now, Petri dishes are these little containers that are super duper important to microbiologists because it allows us to grow microorganisms in a way that we can actually see with our eyes. And you're going to know it for sure after seeing some of the things we grow together in class. It's a pretty simple process, but by doing this, it allows us to see the invisible and to know that the microorganisms that we are learning about in this class are not make-believe. They're not lies someone is telling you just to make you believe in science. No, no, no. They're real and they're all around us. They're a part of our everyday life. They're just really small, so it's easy to overlook them. All right, ladies and gentlemen, here's how you make Petri dishes. Into our little lab, ladies and gentlemen. Here we are, and we're getting ready to make our Petri dishes. It all starts off with agar, okay? And what agar is actually a powder that we get from a seaweed derivative that can sometimes have beef broth mixed into it. And this is what we use to make the little jello-like substance that's in the Petri dishes. Pretty easy process to make it. Come along, let's do it together. Stop looking down at me. All right, everybody. Here's how this is gonna go. We first have to measure out 11.5 grams of agar for the solution we're making. Now, you don't need to remember that. It's on the directions. All right, here's how you scale something. Nice little boop scale. Ooh, our number, wow, it's perfect. Just so you know, whenever you're using a scale like this, that number's weird, so we have to calibrate it or make sure it's set to zero when we're weighing this out. Okay, camera time. And one scoop, and two scoop, and three scoop, and four scoop, and five scoop. Okay, now we're getting close. Now I have to be a little careful. And it's gonna be perfect. And it's gonna be perfect, 11.5. 11.5, yeah. There we go. Next up, ladies and gentlemen, we gotta put all our agar in about 500 milliliters of water. And now I have a little magic trick to show you. I've already told you that I'm going to be able to use my mind to move things. Yes, it's working. Yes, it's working. My telekinesis is activated. Yes, yes, yes. Actually, ladies and gentlemen, that's a stir plate. That's all we're doing. We're playing with our stir plate to make it easier to mix these things together. And you will see that vortex gets going as we increase the speed. Off it goes. All right, now we got a real nice mixture going. I'm now gonna put our 11.5 grams of agar into here. And here we go. Well, now we're just waiting for the agar to mix together, but the next step is to not just mix the powder into the liquid. The next step is to actually heat it up so that way this temperature can cause the reaction, which will be pretty important to making this whole thing turn into the agar that we're using in class. So once it's mixed in, we then put it on a heat plate. And now we just got the mixture heating up. We're gonna bring this all the way to a boil, making sure we don't have a boil over though, which happened more than a few times. Not gonna make you watch this part. It's gonna get hot. Everybody. Now, all we have to do is pour. All right, here it is. The moment of science. Let's see if our Petri dishes have turned solid. Okay, I'm taking this one. I'm worried. I don't know what's gonna happen, but I believe in science. And I think this will work. I know it will work. And I've also done it a bunch of times before. Ladies and gentlemen, Petri dish is now made, okay? What was once liquid is now solid. And that means we get to go to the next part and start taking some samples of the classroom. Wow. All right, so we got our Petri dishes made. Now we just have to figure out how to take a sample of something. So this requires one more piece of technology. A cotton swab, okay? And I got a pretty easy way of showing you how I'm gonna do this. First, you twist, you go take a sample, right? You go take a sample, and we're gonna put it on the Petri dish. Let me show you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna take a sample of this desk right here. Twisting, I'm taking a sample, I'm seeing what's growing. And ladies and gentlemen, there shouldn't be much on the sample. We've been doing a good job of cleaning these desks in here for everyone learning at home. But now, I have my Petri dish, and my swab. I am now gonna gently just go back and forth, making this nice little squiggle design, okay? And that's it. Put the top back on. We label it, and then we go to another little area of the classroom. Here we go, everybody. We're now at the back of the class with Loveridge. Hey-oh, having fun back here. And what we're really doing is we're putting our Petri dish into this incubator. And an incubator is kind of like an oven, but it's a lot more controlled. So it doesn't just heat things up to 350 degrees Fahrenheit and that's it. It allows you to control all the temperatures between 0 and 100 degrees Celsius. And right now, we got this thing set at 36 degrees Celsius, okay? Which in Fahrenheit, it's about body temperature, right? It's around 98 degrees, give or take. Here we go, all we gotta do is put it in and come back later and find out what we got. What about, bee science. All right, everybody, we're here a week later, and now it's time to check out some of our samples. Let's see what's growing in our incubator.
Oh, no, not this one. This isn't what I put in there.
All right, here is the sample that I took from before. All those weird splotches, all those weird little things growing, those are all microorganisms. Let's go check out the rest of our results from the class. Here they are. Here you can see the control from the experiment, which was a set of 10 Petri dishes that were left exposed to the open air for 2 hours. Then the top was put on and they were left at room temperature all this time. The microorganisms you can see here growing are the microorganisms that live all around us every single day. While some of these Petri dishes might look really nasty and really gross, these same microorganisms are some of the ones that are used in food production. and allow us to make some of our sourdough breads or some of our wild fermented fruits and vegetables that many of us have in our household or in our refrigerators right now. Here is all the samples from the in-person students this year for all the students at home to check out what we're doing in class. Everyone, enjoy the show.
Microbe!